Oh yes. Animes. I really like anime. Especially these three. I love Love Live because of how well it portrays emotions, while being hilarious. I love Hiji Hero because of how well it slaps hentai watchers in the face. And I like Gaku Garashai because... IDK, I guess I liked the purple hair girl. Of course, not all animes are the same standards as these three. Some animes are pretty bad. And some animes are blatant copies of previous successes. Actually, Kill Me Baby was pretty okay. And just when I thought I would never watch a spectacular anime ever again, this happened.
But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
I like Tori Tori, because of how it portrays pain and grief while also being a music anime. And I like Spy X Family because it's wholesome and epic. But we're not here to talk about how good Spy X Family is. 84.99999% of you know how good Spy X Family is. Except for Tori Tori, no one watches that.
Quite the story, but for another day.
We're talking about Happy Sugar Life, and talk about why despite the fact I prefer Spy X Family and Tori Tori to Happy Sugar Life, Happy Sugar Life is better than those two anime. No, I'm not joking. I'm dead serious. Ha, did you see what I did? So, it's kinda impossible to talk about Happy Sugar Life without spoilers, so skip to this time frame to avoid spoilers. If you haven't watched Happy Sugar Life, go watch it, by the way, it's pretty good. Okay, so, you might be wondering how I found this anime. If you have seen the teaser trailer for this review, you might know that there's a character in Happy Sugar Life that looks awfully a lot like Nozomi Tojo. And so being the Nozomi fanatic I was, it was a no shit I would watch this anime. So I watched it that weekend and I got hooked on it on the first episode, just like some other anime. I wanna talk about something else first, the animation. I really like the character designs, they somehow made a cute anime girl become this horrifying and threatening monster almost seamlessly. I've never seen animation do that since Nozomi Tojo from Love Live. That's a joke, by the way, I have seen many animations do this before, and each time I see this, I'm impressed, 10 out of 10 animation. And also, the camera shots in a lot of scenes are just fantastic. And did I forget to mention how the OST freaking slaps? I can even say that it slaps harder than Gaku Garashai's OST, and also Delta Yun's OST, and I think you guys know how I feel about Delta Yun's OST. Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers OST slaps. More like... Wait, why the heck am I Latina? And the opening and ending of Happy Sugar Life is also really catchy. The ending has a lot of charm to it and it kinda reminds me of the Assassination Classroom Season 1 AD, Hello Shooting Star, which is my favorite AD of all time. And don't get me started on the OP of Happy Sugar Life, it's the best OP I've ever seen in an anime. It is a very good representation of the entire Happy Sugar Life. Not only is it catchy, not only is the animation for this very vibrant and fluid, not only does this theme song also have a key change that makes the entire experience better, but this OP's lyrics are just the most fitting lyrics I've ever seen in an anime. Sometimes, openings for animes are just very generic songs that don't really add much to the plot. However, this OP has lyrics that tells the audience exactly what the anime is, a dark and gruesome anime about psychopaths. Is this OP my favorite? Nah, friend Shitai is clearly more superior. Take that, Javalia 2.0 decoder. Hold it, buddy, it was a joke.
It was a freaking joke.
I think the best way to summarize how good the animation and soundtrack for this anime is, I think we have to take a look at this scene. There isn't any talking in this scene, it's just the animation and the soundtrack doing the talking, and it's a genius. I'm not really a huge fan of show, not tell, but this anime does it in a way that it's so beautiful and heartbreaking. I can't compliment this anime enough, you have to go and watch it for yourself. I mean, look at that, Shoko freaking scratching Seitu's hand, that's something that is really intense and emotional, and you can feel the pain Shoko is feeling, OMG. Time to talk about the real treat, the story and characters. The story is probably better than Gaku Garashi's story, but I still prefer Gaku Garashi. I love the suspenseful scenes, the emotional scenes and the wholesome scenes, they are all so good, I think about them every night. But we'll get back to that later, I promise. I also really like how Seitu raises up the question of what is love, that is a very valid question and a really great moral from this anime. Unfortunately, I already know what's love. Right, Nozomi?
Right, Koto.
Sometimes when I watch the suspense scenes, I scream and run away, that's how good those scenes are. I also like how, despite the fact that there isn't anything specifically scary going on, this anime makes my limbs super shaky for some reason. I also really like the ending where nobody won, that is the magnum opus of all anime endings I've seen. Absolutely genius writing. Despite all the compliments I give this anime, I still have problems with it. This anime is not funny. I can remember laughing at only two jokes. And I don't think the first joke was meant to be funny. I know how this anime isn't meant to be funny, but like, Gaku Garashi was hilarious, so I don't see why can't Happy Sugar Life be hilarious as well. But I guess that's a lot better than Demon Slayer. I don't remember laughing at any joke in that anime. Actually, I did laugh at that scene where the black-haired boy squishes that white-haired girl, but I immediately stopped laughing when the protagonist stops the boy, like, what the hell? But by far my biggest problem is how this anime has so many plot holes in it, like, what the hell? There's this scene where the teacher gets arrested and it's never given a reason why he is arrested. But I'll be honest, how gives a shit I mean, even the best anime has plot holes. And just like Gaku Garashi, for every negative thing this anime gets, it gets at least 23 other things right. And of course, it's time to talk about the characters. I think it is weird how I almost empathize with almost every character. I really like all of them, but the worst one being the teacher, he deserves to go to jail. I didn't expect myself to empathize with every character in an anime about psychopaths. That's very wrong. I especially like the aunt, and I bet she's going to be the next Delta Yun secret boss. But despite that, I don't trust every character in this anime. They all have this persona that makes them look innocent, but they aren't innocent. I mean, Gravity Falls did touch on that topic and it did it really well. I feel like this anime did it better, since it takes place in the real world other than a fictional world. Happy Sugar Life makes everything not perfect, and that's what makes it perfect, because it's not perfect. It really tells the viewers not to trust anyone, especially your heroes. I was wrong to treat you that way, Ima, sorry. See, now you respect me because Ima threat. But what if there's a character in this anime that's actually perfect? One character even better than our Lord and Savior, Nozomi Tojo.
何か問題がありますか?
Not you, Nozomi, you were perfect, you were better than perfect. It's that Niko Yazawa, she keeps ruining your reputation. To start this video, I need to ask those Happy Sugar Life fans out there a simple question. Which character in Happy Sugar Life do you think deserves Shio the most? Take some time to think about this question and comment down below. Don't even bother, I already know the answer. I can tell just by looking at the comment section in the SoundCloud upload of One Room Sugar Life. But have you ever wondered why, despite the fact that you know that Saitu is wrong, you still defend Saitu and root for her? Explanation Point did a really good job explaining why, and I recommend checking out his video, link in the description below. But I'm not here to do that. Instead, I'm here to rub salt into your happy, sugar life, wound, and eat you up 23 seconds later, because today, we're talking about the pain of Asahi Kobe. So let's start at the early days if the happy sugar life timeline. The time after Love Live School Idol Project. Asahi was born and raised by his mom and his abusive dad. After his younger sister, Shio, was born, his mom decided to flee the house to escape from the dad. But Asahi had to stay behind. So Asahi was constantly getting abused, and got his nails freaking torn off. His dad also gave him commands and stuff. Because of how Asahi was abused, people got a bad reputation of him. You understand why this is sad now. And I'm literally only getting started. 5 years later, Asahi's dad died of poisoning. But what really stands out to me is Asahi's smile in this scene. You can see the joy in his eyes and he is blushing, meaning, he is happy, has heck and tears in his eyes. Do you understand what this means? I've never seen a person so happy over someone's death, which only goes to show how much of a jerk the dad was. But even after all that, Asahi still couldn't find his happy ending. Shio was already gone. And the next part of Asahi's life is Asahi putting up wanted posters for Shio. No, I'm not joking, literally once he realizes that Shio was gone he wasted no time. Asahi gets beaten up by teens because teens are jerks, and Saitu almost kills Asahi because Saitu is jerk. And Asahi immediately gets back to putting up the posters, once he is awake. And he doesn't stop the poster thing, no no no. It goes on for several episodes and it
don't stop coming and they 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 don't stop.
All those homeless people's backstory aren't as sad as his because news flash, he's the homeless person himself. But I guess he got a girlfriend, so that's a plus. Actually, speaking of girlfriend, it's time to talk about the next part of Asahi's story. Shoko Hata. Now I DK about you, but Shoko Hata is my second favorite character in Happy Sugar Life in between Saitu's aunt and Asahi. Like literally everything she does in this anime is something I would actually do and is a character I can relate to. She has her own selfish stuff, but it's not so bad as to make her look as bad as the other characters. But I guess the fandom doesn't like her. And I guess that would mean I would also die in that situation. But anyway, we're not here to talk about a well-developed character, we're here to talk about a well-developed character. So Asahi meets up with Shoko and the two become good friends. Their friendship goes on for several episodes and it's the most wholesome thing I've ever seen, until the best scene in anime history since Gakugurashai's tomato scene. No, I'm not joking, you can make a kiss scene as amazing as an emotional scene. But I mostly just want you guys to remember something from this scene. Now I want you guys to remember that for the rest of this analysis section of the video. Now you guys already remembered that because it's such a well-written line. So after Shoko gets killed in this freaking banger of a scene, Asahi finds Sussy Baka and Asahi beats the shitai out of him, and then Saitu's aunt also beats the shitai out of him. Soon enough, Asahi finds Shio and Asahi and Saitu have this really cool fight scene, but in classic Delta Yun secret boss fashion, Saitu's aunt already burnt the apartment. This made it harder for Asahi to find Shio. Asahi then stumbled upon the corpse of his best friend, Shoko Hata. The best part of this scene is that you can see the pain in his eyes and all of that is portrayed with no dialogue. Asahi eventually finds Shio again, but Shio doesn't want to go with Asahi because she prefers Say 2 more. And let's do the math here. Say 2 states that she has gotten Shio for at least a year already. If the day where Asahi was free from his dad was the same day Shio's mom abandoned her, and let's assume that Asahi went to search for Shio immediately after he realized Shio was missing. This means that for a year straight, Asahi was looking for Shio. And I'm not even counting those episodes that happen after that anniversary episode. Anyway, Shio doesn't want to go with Asahi because of the trauma her mom gave her. Of course, Asahi defends the mom because let's be honest, that's something you would do in that situation. But no matter what you think of Shio's mom, you have to look at Asahi's side. He just wants his young innocent sister back, and he wasn't the one who had terrible phrasing skills. Eventually, he gets back Shio, bringing flowers to visit her. He makes an amazing quote before realizing that Say 2 has reincarnated into Shio. I mean, look at that pain and shock in his eyes. Thanks, Happy Sugar Life. I love your ending so much. After watching the ending of Happy Sugar Life, I went to bed and I just couldn't stop thinking of Asahi Kobe. I thought that talking about him in this video would make me feel better, but to be honest, it just made me feel worse for him, and it made me tear up realizing that Shoko was never right about Asahi smiling. I legit can't imagine Asahi smiling after this entire anime. I only imagined an image of him crying outside of Shio's room. Asahi never did anything specifically wrong, and yet, he gets the bad ending everyone else in the anime had. There's only one time Asahi smiles in the anime, and even the other times Asahi smiles, it's either insanity or just to comfort someone. And that is why Asahi Kobe broke me. You freaked up, Asahi. You're mixing animes with reality. Ok. Sorry if I keep on making Pixar references. I'm really hyped up for Lightyear. A Lightyear review may be coming out, but
don't count on it all.
So basically, this video was just a poor excuse to talk about an anime character I feel really bad for. And also as a birthday celebration for Asahi. But other than that, it's so refreshing to see a spectacular anime once again, after so long. Of course, it's not as good as Gaku Gurashai. Hell, it's not even close to being the same standards as its prequel, Love Live School Idol Project. But it's better than most animes out there. I personally feel this is what Demon Slayer tried to be. A mature story about a boy trying to save his sister. But no, they had to appeal to 8-year-olds. Thanks, Demon Slayer, I hate you so much. Anyway, with a good plot, suspenseful scenes, soundtrack, characters, emotions, and a lot more compliments, I can't think of now. Happy Sugar Life is an anime I would give that rare 9 out of 10 score to. If you can take a horror and slightly pervertic story, I 100% recommend this anime. Heck, I'm not a huge fan of horror animes, but I had a great time watching it. I had a blast watching it, and I had a blast talking about it. Thank you everyone for watching.
But if you close your eyes, does it all matter?